Alright guys, today I want to talk about the area lights inside Octane and C4D. So here is a quick guide on how lights work inside Cinema. There are some handy shortcuts for Octane lights, but if you don't have them, you can just come over here to Objects, and then Lights Area Lights. So here I set up a simple scene with a reflective material and a roughness map. So let's bring the subject here. Let's move the light and rotate it around so it's affecting the TV a bit more. If I turn off the light, we have a diffuse appearance, and that's because a default environment with a gray texture is active. If we go to our Octane settings and then click on Settings, we can change the default environment color to black. Everything is now black. If we turn the light back on, we should be able to bring out the shadows a little better. Let me change the floor material so we can see shadows better. Sharper shadows can be achieved by scaling down the light, but doing so reduces brightness, which creates an issue. In order to fix this, we may deactivate the surface brightness control in the Octane light tag, which will decouple the scale from the brightness. Let's scale this down once again, and as we do so, you'll notice that the shadows become more defined. And then of course, the reverse is true, where the larger we scale it up, the softer our shadows will get. You can also add a target to your light by right-clicking and going to Animation Tags Target, or another option is to create directly a targeted area light here. You can find it here under Objects, come down to Lights, and then Octane Targeted Area Light, and then add your target on the target object here. Let's add our TV as the target. So now wherever I move the light, it will be facing the TV. Now let's see what are the light settings here in our Octane light tag. Here is the power, so it's the light intensity. And then temperature is in Kelvin. As we bring it towards a lower value, we get much warmer. And then the opposite's value will get something much more bluer. You can also add colors with this texture slot. Go to Plugins, C4D Octane, then RGB Spectrum. From here you can change the light color you want. We can also do that with the node editor. By clicking the icon here, you can jump in the node editor, then grab an RGB spectrum and putting it into the texture. You can also add a texture to your light. Again, plug in C4D Octane, then image texture. Then we can jump into this here and find a texture. Let's grab this one. We can see some colors of the texture on the shadow. If we want this to sharpen up, we need to scale down the light and turn on surface brightness. As you can see, it doesn't work as expected. So let's put the texture inside the distribution slot. So let's copy the shader here. Clear it. And paste it on the distribution slot. Now you can see that the texture is projected on here. Let's clear this out. There's also this double-sided control which adds light coming from the opposite side as well. Next we have Normalize, which keeps the intensity of the light the same no matter what color value you have. So you can see that if I go towards the red or blue, the intensity remains the same. If I uncheck the Normalize box, you will see that if I bring the Kelvin value lower, it's actually darken the light. And then as we bring it to the higher Kelvin values, this brightens up. Next we have visible and diffuse. If we uncheck that, then we're only seeing the light contribution in the specular. And then if we uncheck visible on specular too, we won't see the TV at all. If I turn back on diffuse, it's only applying as a diffuse component. Cast shadows if uncheck. Your light won't cast shadow anymore. Opacity slider is the opacity of the light. It just fades all the way off until it's no longer visible to the camera. Now with this light pass ID, we can do controls light linking. Let's say we set this to pass 2. What we can do if we don't want the light to affect the floor, we can add an Octane object tag to our floor. So right clicking on the floor, C4D Octane Tags, Octane Object Tag. Here, under Object Layer, we can turn this Light Pass Mark to Enable, and then untick Pass 2. So now the light is no longer affecting the floor. We can also change the shape of the light by going on the Octane Light object itself, then go to Details, and here under Area Shape, you can change the light shape. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you have learned something today, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. See you on the next video.